Tropical Cyclone Kirrily is now a severe Category 3 system, expected to cross the Queensland coast later this evening. This upgrade from Category 2 to Category 3 severe tropical cyclone occurred at the 3 p.m. issue of our Tropical Cyclone Forecast Track Map. The reason for this upgrade is that our expectations around the peak wind gusts for this coastal crossing have shifted up slightly. We're now expecting to see some of those peak gusts potentially reaching 170 kilometres an hour. Broadly speaking, though, the other details of this coastal crossing haven't changed. Our warning area is largely the same. The timing of the coastal crossing late this evening is still the same. And the location of the coastal crossing is still largely the same. The impacts felt will still be largely the same as they were. We're just now meeting that threshold to be categorised as a severe Category 3 tropical cyclone. At the moment, severe tropical cyclone Kirrily is sitting around 150 kilometres to the east-northeast of Townsville, wrapping bands of showers and storms around it, lashing onto the coast. We've seen some moderate rainfall totals already today, the highest being around 100 millimetres at Clark Range, which is just inland from Mackay. And we've also seen some very strong wind gusts, mostly at the offshore reefs. Around 142 kilometres an hour has been seen at Flinders Reef, with around 114 kilometres an hour at the Whitsundays. But it is worth keeping in mind that these are the peak gusts. The sustained winds, so the average wind speeds over a longer period of time, have also been incredibly high. And it's these very strong, sustained winds that we expect to see pushing onto those coastal mainland areas over the next few hours. So breaking that down now, our tropical cyclone warning zone extends from Innisfail to Serena and includes Townsville and Mackay. Inland, it extends to Charters Towers and towards Hughenden. Severe tropical cyclone Kirrily, the Category 3 system, is expected to maintain its Category 3 intensity as it moves southwest towards the Queensland coast through the rest of this afternoon. We'll see those sustained gale force winds and heavy rainfall really picking up through our warning area. And the combination of the winds and the rain do have the potential to bring down trees and power lines, leading to road closures and possible power failures. In addition to the winds and rain, though, we could see a dangerous storm tide with this system as it moves through. Now, at this stage, that's unlikely to occur at the high tide, which is good news, but we are still expecting to see some abnormally high tides around the time of the crossing. In addition to that storm tide, we're likely to see large waves and dangerous swells. The crossing is likely to occur late this evening, most likely in the vicinity of Townsville. The severe tropical cyclone Kirrily is likely to be a Category 3 system at that time, and as it crosses the coast, that is when we'll see the most intense impacts. Our wind gusts may reach as much as 170 kilometres an hour just to the south of the system, with more widespread destructive wind gusts up to 155 kilometres an hour. That is most likely to impact areas to the west and south of the system, but may spread northwards up the coast towards Cardwell as well. As the system moves across the coast and inland, it will rapidly decay, reaching a Category 1 system by early tomorrow morning, and then dropping back to a tropical low by tomorrow afternoon. The wind gusts will back down as that system moves inland, but strong and gusty winds, possibly damaging, are still expected as that system has decayed. In terms of the rainfall, we're also expecting the heaviest rain with the coastal crossing. We could see hundreds of millimetres coming through in just a period of 6 or 8 hours as this system moves across the coast. That could very quickly lead to flash flooding, and in its wake, we could see that riverine flooding cropping up as well, which is why we have flood watches current for large parts of this coast. As the system moves inland, it will carry a lot of that moisture with it, gradually pushing it across the more central and then into the western parts of Queensland through the later part of tomorrow, going into the weekend. Because of this ongoing risk of heavy rainfall, we do now have a severe weather warning current for that rainfall that is likely to occur in the wake of the cyclone once it's decayed back to a tropical low. It covers these inland areas pushing towards the Northern Territory border and is likely to start developing through the day, overnight Friday going into Saturday. So heavy rainfall that could be locally intense and lead to flash flooding is likely in this area, as well as some locally damaging winds. Now you might be asking yourself, why have we got a severe weather warning current when we've also got a tropical cyclone warning current? Well, if I overlay both of them, we can see that where one finishes, the other starts. The reason for this is once the system is no longer a tropical cyclone, it won't get a tropical cyclone warning. Once it's a low, we'll have a severe weather warning covering the impacts from that system. They're both warning for the same dangers, however, the heavy rain and the strong winds in particular. With many warnings already current and more expected over the coming days, it's essential to keep up to date, especially with that tropical cyclone crossing expected late this evening. Stay safe, listen to emergency services, and we'll catch you in the next update.